Hello everyone, today we are going to demonstrate magnetic levitation principles using a floating spinning top. In the other videos, we explained that it is not possible to achieve full levitation just by using permanent magnets. If you stabilize the permanent magnet in one direction, it becomes unstable in the normal plane. If we want to make an object levitate through electromagnetic means, we need to use additional techniques, like active control of the magnetic field, diamagnetic materials, or induced currents. However, electromagnetic forces are not the only way to stabilize the position of a floating object. In this video, we discuss a fascinating mechanical phenomenon. Let us talk about the gyroscopic effect. Gyroscopic effect is a phenomenon that happens on rotating objects. When you ride a bicycle, it is due to the gyroscopic effect that you can keep the bicycle in a stable, straight position, as long as you keep the wheel spinning. Also, when you spin a spinning top, gyroscopic effect is what allows the top to keep spinning without falling to the side. As long as the top keeps rotating, gravity will try pulling the top downwards, but instead of falling, its rotating axis performs a circular movement around the contact point. This movement is what we call precession. Due to the combination of gyroscopic effect and repulsive magnetic forces, it is possible to make a spinning top float on thin air. Let's see how this works. These are the parts that came along with this magnetic toy. We have a magnetic base, the spinning top itself, a plastic plate, two wedges to adjust the position of the magnetic base, and a set of washers to adjust the weight of the spinning top. The spinning top is made of a disc-shaped permanent magnet. Inside the square base, there is a toroidal permanent magnet. Due to the magnetic field distribution, an unstable balance point occurs over the magnetic base. However, when the top is spinning, it has a tendency to keep the same rotation axis, due to the gyroscopic effect. So, if the spinning top leaves the balance point, its rotational axis is pulled back into this magnetic trap. Now that we know how it works, let's give it a try. Well, making this top float for the first time is not easy at all. First, you have to practice spinning it in the center position until you succeed. After achieving a satisfactory spin, you need to raise the platform gently. If, while raising the platform, the spinning top is launched and escapes the magnetic field, it means that it is too light and we need to increase the weight using the washers. On the other hand, if the top doesn't stay trapped in the stable region and falls back to the plate, it means that the top is too heavy. We need to reduce the weight by changing the washers. If the top looks stable for some time but keeps falling to the same side, it means that the magnetic base has an inclination. We need to adjust the wedges to compensate this. If it is falling to one side, you either raise the same side or you lower the opposite one. After finding this sweet spot where everything is adjusted, you can keep the top floating for a very long time, until it loses speed and falls. The amount of weight necessary to find a stable position depends on some things. Metal objects near the spinning top may affect the magnetic field distribution. When trying this by yourself, you should avoid metal desks. Even if no metallic objects are around, there's a possibility that the magnet temperature will affect the strength of the magnetic field. Due to variables like this, every time you try levitating the spinning top, you may need to adjust the weight again. Thank you for your attention. I hope this video increased your interest in magnetic levitation.